Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, friends. Welcome back to my channel. Today I have this power supply. It is 12 volt 10 ampere. It is not powering on. How we can troubleshoot it, how we will test it, and how we will repair it. Let's start. If you don't have a good practical experience in power electronics, never try to repair at yourself, because it have live electrical voltage. It may be cause of some dangerous electrical shock. Now I will apply power, and when you are applying power to any unit under test, always use isolation transformer and use series lamp to protect the circuit from more damage. I am using series lamp here, and I will apply power. It is 220 volt operated. Now I will apply power. AC voltage, it is 235 volts, but if I will check, the output voltage, there are no voltage, there is no LED indication and no voltage. Now we have two screws, one screw here, the second one here. We will open it and we will remove the chassis cover. First of all, inspect it carefully that if there is any visual damage, nothing. Check this switch at 220 volt, that's okay. And no capacitor damage, capacitors are looking good. MOSFET, no blast, no any black sign. Let's check it. Now in the first step, we need to check the fuse. Yes, the fuse is good. That means we have problem in the next circuit. And it is using KA7500, that is TL494. KA7500 and TL494 are the same. In the first step, we will check the supply voltage on this IC. Now, the first safety point. Never touch any component when the power is applied. Now we check the voltage, AC voltage here at the fuse. There is no voltage drop, that means the fuse is good. Now we need to check voltage on these capacitors. DC voltage, check voltage on these bleeder resistors, which is connected parallel to this capacitor. 167 volt on this capacitor, 168 volt on this capacitor. Both capacitors are good. Now we need to check the switching, either the switching is started or not. For that purpose, check DC voltage at pin number 7 and 12. 7 is ground for this KA7500 or TL494. If it is using TL494 or KA7500, the same. 7 and pin number 12, 9 9 10 11 12, there are no voltage. That means the problem in this high power area, it is not taking a startup, initial start from these MOSFETs. For that purpose, we will check the voltage on these two diodes. DC voltage, at this diode no voltage, at this diode 336 volt. That means there is problem in the MOSFETs, in the MOSFET and in these components. There is something bad in this area. It must be balanced. It is not turning on. Now I removed power. And now we will remove the PCB. First of all, we need to verify the voltage on these capacitors. That is the basic safety point. Still, it is discharging because these bleeder resistors are discharging. When the power is removed, these resistors will discharge this capacitor. If there are voltage on the capacitors, never touch to any component. Remove the heatsink for this, the output rectifier. Now I separated the PCB and we need to check these components. Set multimeter to the diode. Check this diode. Yes, this diode is short circuit. This one side okay. The second side block. That's good, forward and reverse. But this diode, it's short circuit from both sides. First we will remove this diode, which is giving continuity, to verify it, either it is problematic or not. Now I am removing this diode for surety. In one side, it is giving continuity, forward voltage. Second side, it is open. That means this diode is good. Now, because this diode is good, so we will install back in the PCB. Now, if we check across this diode, we have this MOSFET. From this point and this point, that means our this MOSFET is maybe damaged. Now I am removing this MOSFET for testing. Yes, it is short circuit. Now we can check here. This diode which we installed back, now it is good. Now we need to verify these resistors. This resistor, it is 2.4 ohms and our this resistor, yes, it is not giving good resistance, so we need to verify it. This 10 ohm resistor, this okay, this one is okay. Check the diodes. This one is good, this one is good. In the reverse condition, it's good. Here in the reverse, it's good. And we need to check this 2.5k resistor. This one, it's okay. This one, okay. This resistor, 150k, yes, 150k, 150k, and this diode is good. This diode is good. But our this resistor is not giving good reading. For that purpose, we will remove the MOSFET and we will also verify this MOSFET. Yes, it is short circuit. We need to replace the board. So it is a transistor. It is not a MOSFET. It is D130077. Now I arrange these two transistors. This one, these are in metallic tape. When I will install, I need to install a insulation between the metallic chassis and the transistor tab. It is NPN transistor, high power transistor. The leftmost pin, that is base. connect to the leftmost pin, collector and emitter, 0.593 0.559 0.560, that's good. Collect reverse connection between emitter to collector, it's good. This one, red lead at the leftmost pin, this one is good, this one is good. Between base to emitter, this is good. This is our damaged transistor, and this one is also base to collector damaged. Now we will replace this resistor. This resistor is open circuit, we will replace it. And I have the same 2.2 ohm resistors. It is not the exact wattage. I will install just for trial purpose and then I will replace with the original one, because this time I don't have with the exact wattage rating. For trial purpose I will install this one. Now I will remove this 2.2 ohm resistor. I will install just for trial purpose, just for testing. If the circuit will work, we will replace with the original wattage. Now I will install these transistors. Yes, we can see it is now powered on. Yes. Now the circuit is powered on. And now we can check voltage across this diode. It is 167. And here 167. So both diodes must have the same voltage. This was our condition, that due to damage in base collector and emitter, there were no voltage drop. All the voltage were dropping here, and this transistor was also short circuit, and this resistor was short circuit. Now I will replace with the original resistor, original voltage, and this time we have voltage here at pin number 7 8 9 10 11 12. We have 20 volt on the pin number 12, that's good. And we have 4.987 reference voltage, and this time pin number 4 must be ground, must be low. If it is above than 1 volt, the IC will turn off. For TL494, KA7500, pin number 4 must be low. I hope so you enjoyed this video. If it is good, hit the like button. If you have any question, write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.